and this, and then this, and this. If you ever play it that fast again, you're out of your mind.
Two, three, up.
Take your foot off the soft pedal. No, no. I prefer if you play Beethoven. I want you having a row with your boyfriend. Boom! Don't give up on me. Do you? Ah! When I, aged 18, announced I was going to do music for my career, my mother nearly, I mean, she went berserk. World War III happened in our family because she thought I was going to do something significant in my life and not just music. Yeah, no. Yeah. I'm working harder than you are. Come on. Take your foot off. Ah, go away out of that. He writes fortissimo. Come on, shout at me. Ah. That's not what he wrote. I'm going to actually tie your left leg to the chair.
South of Naples, clinging to the rugged Amalfi coast, sits the town of Positano. The perfect place to get married, fall in love, have an affair, or just go shopping. Yes, it gets crowded, but who cares when it's done Italian style? However, not everyone comes to soak up the sun, chill out and shop. In a villa overlooking the town for 2 weeks every year, Dubliner John O'Connor gives a masterclass to some of the best young pianists from all over the world. Here, he's following in the footsteps of one of his own teachers, renowned German concert pianist Wilhelm Kempf. These are lessons in piano playing, in the music of the great Ludwig von Beethoven, and in a way, in life.
Hi, Charlene. Yes?
Yeah.
Okay. I think it's a big deal to be part of the class. The amount of teachers around the world who get in touch with me and say, do you have another place? The fact that I'm already full each year, 7 or 8 months before the course takes place. People will say, if they can't come this year, can they come next year? And can I put their name on the list? And teachers are starting to say the same thing to me. So yeah, it's a big deal.
John O'Connor is one of the most respected musicians to ever come out of Ireland.
There you go.
His wife Mary and his sons Hugh and Keith keep him firmly grounded.
Come around to the interval.
I will, of course.
Yeah. Okay,
bye. Have to come around and tell him it's great. Bye, good luck.
Bye, goodness. I often call that long walk down the corridor the walk to the scaffold. It's going to the stage. Once you get on, you can do something about it, but waiting beforehand, you can only think of what can go wrong. I mean, you are always uptight before it falls. I suppose I'm not as nervous as I used to be because I've played these works so often.
Thank you, thank you.
In 1973, O'Connor was unanimously awarded first prize at the International Beethoven Piano Competition in Vienna. From there, his concert and recording career took off, and he's now in demand all over the world. In Ireland, John is director of the Royal Irish Academy of Music and the co-founder of the AXA Dublin International Piano Competition. He has been hailed as a true poet of the piano in the Japanese press and described as a visionary with a flawless touch by the Washington Post.
I would not be where I am today except for the teachers I had. And I think it's the responsibility of every pianist to pass it on to the next generation.
This year's masterclass has some very strong contenders. Canadian Marie-Charlene Fourcroy is praised for her sensitive playing. She is based in Cologne, and though she has won many prizes, she has come to Positano in the hope that she will build her confidence to help move her career up a gear. Russian Peter Ovcharov is based in Salzburg, where he's won many scholarships. He regularly performs with Austrian and German orchestras and has successfully toured in Japan. Although all the students agreed to speak English, Peter insisted on using German when outside the class. John Kwan was born in South Korea and now lives in America. His career to date hasn't all been plain sailing, as he's been torn between his love of music and the demands of his family to join their business. In the past, he has received substantial financial assistance from the Jerry Seinfeld Family Foundation. John needs to prove himself here if his career is to go anywhere. Amanda Gessler and Kevin Corkle are an American couple who will take the class together. Kevin is from Seattle, Washington. He started his musical life playing jazz trumpet, but at 18 devoted himself entirely to classical piano. He won a scholarship to the University of Washington and is currently studying for his master's degree at the Royal Irish Academy as a student of John O'Connor. Amanda is from Wisconsin and she was homeschooled, so she came out of nowhere when at 17 she was awarded a scholarship to the Lawrence Conservatory of Music. She was a prize winner at the Chicago Symphony Orchestra competition and has also performed in Aspen and Vienna. After this masterclass, Hong Chun must return to South Korea for his compulsory national service in the armed forces. He is a graduate of the art school in Seoul and attended the New England Conservatory in Boston, where he was awarded the most promising student. He has toured America and Europe and has already made many recordings. Darshini Tambaya is from a Sri Lankan family based in London and she has already made her solo debut at Carnegie Hall. She won the Jury's Special Prize for French Music in Athens and is currently working on her master's degree in Florida. Over the next 2 weeks, these seven young people will find out if O'Connor believes they've got what it takes to be professional musicians.
All of these young pianists have played many concerts before. They've often done many international competitions. But playing for the first time in the course, they're all nervous. We're going to start with Opus 2, number 2, and that means, Darshi, you're starting, okay? So can we have the first movement? All right, thank you. I think I know it. I put it there anyway. Okay. To actually play first on the course, everybody hates. I mean, they really do. Somebody told me recently that a lot of pianists, they've learned about the course and they particularly don't choose one of the early sonatas, so they don't have to play first.
I'd heard rumours that the person playing Opus 2, number 1, wasn't here yet. So that was a bad moment because I just thought, oh no, I do not want to be first. It's not possible to warm up before the classes. So we're all coming in the morning, having just woken up and cold, basically, fingers-wise.
First thing, it's too nice.
Is it?
Yes, it's too nice. Beethoven was many things. He was never really nice. You know, he was never polite. He was never a joy to be around in the sense of that you could bring him to a party and knew that he was always going to behave himself. And when we're talking about Beethoven, a lot of it is to do with the man. Beethoven, we realize, was one of the first musicians who refused to come in the servant's entrance. If somebody invited him, he had to come in the front door. He was that arrogant and stubborn. So therefore, when you're going to play the sonata, you don't start off by going... That's not Beethoven. You have to go... And it has to have an electric quality from the very beginning when you start off. Okay, I'll do this. And then you do that. Yes, when I did more there, you did more there as well.
Yeah.
More. More. Yes, I think Darshi will teach. I think she'll be a wonderful teacher. I think she will also perform.
I personally really love teaching, so it's not really a problem. But I remember when I was living in London, it was very, very expensive. And so actually I tried to practice piano and teach and have about three other jobs as well, which was really, really hard.
This is more like it.
When he's trying to get me going, and I think sometimes I do need a bit of getting going, it's almost impossible not to play much more energetically.
This, and more, and... Can I have five notes? Five notes. Strong hands. Shake hands with me. Yes, exactly, thank you. I hate people who give the wet fish handshake. You know? They'll do that. I can't stand it. So don't play the piano that way.
You know, when people say, how do you know so much about Beethoven? And I talk about, you know, the fact that Haydn taught Beethoven. Beethoven taught Czerny. Czerny taught Liszt. Liszt taught Tausig. Tausig taught Barth. Barth taught Kempf. Kempf taught me. So, I mean, there is a direct line there back to Beethoven and Haydn. It's not necessarily that we pass it on in the same way, but there's a certain amount of one generation passing on to the next generation. And that's something that they need to realize, that it's not just something I'm making up out of nowhere. Mandy first came to study with me in Aspen. I realized that she's somebody who's very determined. She's had a difficult background in her home life, and I think she's coming to terms with that and is using music very cleverly. She doesn't have much money. Yes, some of that was wonderful. Just a very practical thing. Be very careful when you're playing very loud and when you're doing this big climax, that you, even if you're, when your hand is at its strongest, that your wrist is loose. It's just be careful. I'm always terrified of people getting tendonitis, and that comes from tightening up the wrist too much. You need to go relax, relax, and in between you should be like jelly so that you don't actually put too much weight on the tendons, because otherwise you can inflame them and you might have to give up playing the piano. Do it again. Just do it again. Yes, I feel that your third, there's not enough weight coming from the arm on the third finger on the B. Give me your hands for a minute. Put against mine. Okay, now can you imagine that thumb, 5, 3, I think that her interpretations are incredibly strong in many ways. And I think that if she gets the breaks, she could be something very special. It's not happened yet. She's not given up yet either. Even without the F sharp, She does definitely need luck on her side, but then every pianist needs luck on their side. I often say, you know, my career started when I won first prize in the Beethoven competition in Vienna. If it had been a different jury, they might have given it to somebody else. I think you have to be ready for the luck. I think you have to have done the work, and you have to also have interpersonal skills so that people not only like your playing, but also like working with you as a person and float off. Yes. Okay. I think we'll take a break. I think we all need it. Just always be careful here.
Yeah.
You know that that you...
I'm surprised I've never had problems, but
yeah.
I'm sure they'll come if I don't fix it.
If you don't fix it, yes. There is a huge amount of interaction between the professor and the students. But as Kempf always said, this is not so much teacher-pupil relationship. This is people talking about Beethoven. Of course, the idea is to encourage them to know so much about Beethoven that the way they'll play it is not necessarily my way or Kempf's way, but their own way. You have to encourage them to develop their own voice. John is a strange situation. He studied in Juilliard when he was in his late teens and early 20s. And I believe that his parents, or his father, I'm not sure which, put a lot of pressure on him not to do music and to go into the family business, which is in Chicago somewhere. He did this being a dutiful son, and I think he's regretting it now. So he's a couple of years older and finding that he needed to do music to satisfy himself on a personal level. Beethoven in tremendously good humor and showing off purely his virtuosity. This is, you know, so that the Viennese audience would say, wow, he plays the piano very well.
Very difficult.
Very difficult movement. Yes, very difficult movement. Just let's have it again and really sort of and bounce.
He just shows what is in the music very conspicuously. So you know vividly what's going on.
Really tremendous. It's like sort of, I don't know, having a sorbet or something like that. It should be so refreshing, this movement.
Rather than other teachers going through for 4 to 5 hours, with John, 1 minute.
We need to be able to move our fingers in about 10 different ways. You need to actually practice pulling the fingers. Yes, but you're doing it from there. You need to do it from a flatter finger.
Yes.
Can you enjoy it a little bit more?
He needs to have more self-confidence. He doesn't have enough. He's always questioning, saying, this is not good, this is not good. And yet he plays extremely well. He has a very fine technique.
Yes, I mean, you have to end off with exuberance. It's a wonderful sonata. And people at the end of it sort of are sitting there saying, wow, we mustn't hear you worry at the piano. Okay, thank you very much indeed.
I think people tend to think of pianists as delicate creatures who play classical music, so they must be sort of ethereal or wimpish or something like that. And that annoys me because I think training a pianist is as physically demanding on the part of both teacher and student as training an athlete.
Give me a hand. Push. Yes, push against me. That's it. Now, do this with your... keeping the hand, the back of the hand strong. Do this with your fingers. Yeah, you see, the back of the hand can be strong, you can still be loose in the fingers.
Yeah.
So keep that.
Oh, okay.
Yes, but if you want the notes to sound, the actual hand has to be like a talon of an eagle. And yes.
Okay.
Piano playing's not for wimps. With guys, I can do it. Girls, I can't touch them now, but I often put my fist onto their arm and I say, I want you to feel your upper arm working there, okay? So that you actually, you're using all of this part of the weight, not just from there, so that you actually, the whole thing. And also, feel as though your shoulder blades, just go from the beginning. Move. Okay, now, just feel as though, it's not so much that you have to use that amount of sound all the time. It's just that you have that at your disposal. Play me the theme, just. Yeah. A lot more, not so much that. Do it again. Now pull. Come on. Yes, pull the fingertips. So very strong, yes. I want you to feel as though it's coming from your back. Pull from your back. Yes, and pull the fingers. Now, each one of the fingers separate. No, you're tightening up your elbow as you do it. Just the fingers to your back, the connection between this and back here. Just try it. Have you any tickles? Aha! Yes, okay. Now, you drag that. All right, come on. Bump, bump. Come on. That's more like it. Use your body. Okay, whenever you're ready.
Kevin first studied with me in Aspen. I find it difficult to get him to relax so that he actually emotes more. And that's what I need. There, he's doing it there. But somehow, when he gets out on stage, he suddenly goes stoic on me.
Okay. You're worrying too much. I mean, the thing is that you play it so well, I need to hear your enthusiasm. I need to hear you sort of almost stamping your foot and sort of going, yeah! Look at that girl. And look at that one. Well, wow, look at those ones. You know, I mean, just sort of see the thing three different ways. Come on. Yes, but this. One phrase. Yes, but you, I mean. I love it when my students tell me to shut up and leave me alone. It's great. That's what I like to hear. Come on, do it again.
It's easy to talk about the particulars of how to play the piano, but I mean, he does so much more for me. I don't think I've ever had a teacher that gets me so far out of my shell, which is sort of, you know, what I need to do much more of.
Two, three, four. Two, three, four. Two, three, four. Right, okay. Now you will remember it every
He has
time,
a real right? chance.
Just imagine you.
If he's prepared to develop his sense of fantasy, his sense of imagination, his sense of tone color, he can do everything now. What he needs to do is to imagine in his head, you know, what could be possible. And it's with students when everything is right and it's still not special, I say to them, it's walk in the woods time. They need to go out and actually imagine what could be.
Yeah. know. I want you to shout at me.
Okay.
Go on. Jump. 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 Yes, that's it. That's more like it. But this is much more like it. I mean, even when you gave me the filthy look, it was great. It was much more like Beethoven. That's what I want to see. I want you giving me dirty looks much more often.
Sorry to make you work so hard.
I know, I think I work harder than anybody else. I'm exhausted. Okay, thank you. It was very good. Really. Very good. Okay. More. Okay? To get on this course, you know, they have to show that they're already performers. So therefore, and when they're this good, you have to give them that much.
When it's time to play the concertos in class, O'Connor takes the orchestral part.
Number one. It's annoying if you give a place to somebody on the recommendation of a teacher and you suddenly realise when they arrive that they're only doing it because their teacher told them they should, that they don't have a personal interest, because they've taken the place away from somebody else who would have learned an awful lot more, and that's frustrating. Peter came, I think, with an idea that he knew exactly how to play Beethoven, and he has a fantastic technique. He has excellent qualities. To be shouting at the piano an awful lot. There needs to be an awful lot more finesse. And also, you need to be very careful when you play a concerto. If you use the soft pedal so much, you might as well go home. Because a lot of the time, if there are 88 orchestral musicians on stage, they will play louder than you. So you have to be very careful when you are playing softly. If you use the soft pedal, normally you won't be heard.
You have to have a greater self-knowledge about where you are in the musical world. You have to admire the qualities that are good and develop those, but you have to also work on the ones that don't work.
I know one. If I play really dull. If I play really dolce here, so
yes.
Nobody can hear me if I play with orchestra. So that's because we mostly have to show melody in the grid hole with orchestra.
So if you play dolce, nobody will hear you?
Yeah, yeah. Mostly. Because orchestra plays piano, but piano for the orchestra is...
Do you know what instruments are playing there?
Hmm?
Do you know what instruments...
Yeah, there's strings at this
yes.
moment.
Yes, so it's not so loud.
Good orchestra is not so loud. Yeah.
That's not what he wrote. That's not what he wrote.
Where?
Here. Da, 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 da. Yes, but if you... Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yes, for me, this is much more beautiful than what you're doing. There's much more intensity in it.
He's one of the few students that I wouldn't worry if I never saw him again in my life, whereas I keep in contact with all the other students. At times I felt like saying, you know, go home. I don't feel I'm getting through to you.
If you live in Germany, you should sometime go along to the Beethoven house in Bonn and have a go on one of his pianos. I mean, if you played some of it as loudly as you're playing it at present, then the legs would fall off, the strings would all break and the thing would collapse. So be careful that you don't play Beethoven like Bartok. Or something.
My life wasn't the easiest when I was younger. I mean, people look at you and think, because you're into classical music, you must come from an elite background and all this. Not necessarily. Most classical musicians come from quite modest backgrounds. To actually make it, you need to be stubborn, be arrogant, be... work like crazy. And that's the difficulty. You can't describe to people how much you really must work to keep going. And then you have to go to the parties and be nice to people.
After a long day in the masterclass, O'Connor still manages to take some time out and meet the many local dignitaries and visiting friends who want to shake his hand and welcome him and Mary back to Positano. This gathering was at the Villa Mora, named after its Irish owner, Mora Tessier. But John can't party too hard, as he has a lot of teaching to do in the morning, and a masterclass doesn't always go according to plan, especially for those who come unprepared.
Mary Charlene, she's very unsure of herself in some way. And that is something that I'm constantly trying to tell her, that she needs to build up her self-confidence more, because sometimes that comes across on stage. If you walk on stage and you say, I hope you like this, people can say yes or no. But if you walk on stage with an arrogance and or with a self-confidence and say, you must like this, I have something with burning intensity to show you, then that's good. That needs to come across a little bit more. Okay, he's having great fun. Whoops. Ha. I mean, it's almost a little bit Marx Brothers. How about this, Sonata? You know, this is what I keep on saying, is that the people sort of underestimate Beethoven, that he actually could have a twinkle in his eye from time to time.
Okay, he really wants you to try to open yourself, and this is what he really did with me, like, open yourself. And then... when you open yourself more, he will give more. And it's like sort of going always like this, you know? Like.
I'm not sure that she wants or even expects to have a solo career, even though she will give probably many solo concerts, and certainly has the technique and the musicianship to do that. But she has tremendous interpersonal relationships with other musicians, so she does a lot of chamber music. It's very important how to build a career. I talk to my students a lot about that, because not everybody will be a concert pianist. Not everybody should be a concert pianist. And big, big. That's it. That's more like it. And very strong the last two chords. Okay.
The first time I got to know piano was when I was in kindergarten. And I remember going to the instrument during the break and sit there and try to practice, I mean, try to see what it sounds like. There was an energy that was calling me from the piano. I knew somehow right away that I was going to do this for my life.
You have to realize a couple of things. First of all, if it sounds jagged, if it sounds like this, don't... Hong Chung is very talented. I mean, he really is. He's got something quite spiritual in his playing. He's got a wonderful technique.
Not pianissimo.
Yes, and you've got to imagine you're shocking the ladies after dinner with the last two chords, that the fans are going like crazy saying, he's very angry today, isn't he? You know, give it to him. Don't apologize. Good. He could make it. I mean, I really do think. If he gets the breaks, there's no doubt about it that he could have a major career. He needs to, as it were, get around in the community a little bit more so that everybody hears him. But he has tremendous potential.
Good. And then this, every note.
Some young people just sit there and wait for the career to happen, and they don't go out and fight for it. Careers don't happen that way. they have to actually develop a mechanism of learning how to deal with the business side of music, how to deal with accountants, how to deal with how do you get to travel there. The people who can actually live with themselves if they're on tour for 6 weeks, some people just can't hack it. They want to give it up, they feel too lonely.
All right, thank you very much.
You know the ones who are talented, you know the ones who have the sensitivity. You can only guess at the inner reserves that are in some people, and you wait for them to show it themselves.
Just when everyone had settled into the course and the students had all played, some devastating news came from America.
Can I make a phone call?
Yes.
I have to call the consulate.
Kevin's mother had died suddenly. He had to leave Positano and take the first plane home. Amanda decided to go with him.
I think the most disturbing thing about this course was Kevin's mother's death. I mean, we were all deeply affected by it. I'm so sorry that he had to leave. And Mandy is, I mean, I admired her for being so loyal to go with him because she'd hardly played.
As life continues on as normal for the people of Positano and the many holidaymakers, it's a very different story for the young pianists as they get in some last-minute practice for a concert in the Basilica.
Yeah, the acoustic is just really big because of the way it's in the church, you know, so it's all emphasizing everything.
Being here for almost 2 weeks, listening exclusively to Beethoven, playing exclusively Beethoven. And you would imagine, wouldn't you, that would really, really be overkill. But actually, I'm finding more and more it's the opposite.
Sometimes you think, oh, God, I really don't want to practice. But still, the reason why you're a musician is because you're in love with the music, so you don't mind staying hours and hours. You really have to do it if you want to reach something.
Peter is a typical man. Like, man, you know, robust and unexpected, and like this has these fighting qualities. So usually, male musicians tend to have this feminine qualities, but with Peter, I haven't found that sensitive qualities. But he's a great guy, great friend of us, and it's just that he's a lot of time. It depends on how he feels. Oh yeah, he's coming. Yes. Okay. Come on.
When I go to try a new piano, it's like meeting a new person and I have to adjust myself into it. I don't think it's like necessary practicing, but just to getting to know this instrument. I was raised Catholic, and I remember my mother used to sing in the church choir when I was very young. So I, when I was in the kindergarten, I used to go to church and wait for her.
Classical music started in church, the Western music, and as a believer, I hope that the whole performance thing becomes a religious activity rather than just having fun. I believe God is present, so. On the surface, everyone tried to be nice to each other, and we are all friends, but in many ways, it can be very sensitive when it comes to a special goals, like competitions or even in the same concerts.
Thank you.
To mark the 50th anniversary of the Kempf Masterclass, the students will give a recital before an invited audience. There is much anticipation, and nerves are jangling.
It's a great honor to have this concert in this church where Wilhelm Kempf himself played.
Please welcome.
This was a very important concert. There were a lot of people there from Germany, from Kemp's hometown. There were a lot of very important musical people from all around the Amalfi Coast. Well done. Bravo. Bravo. And you looked wonderful too, both of you. Yes.
Some things happy, some things not happy, but that's the way it always is, you know.
There were good things, I would say. No, generally I'm happy.
I don't answer such questions.
One thing about Kempf is he always wanted to give his love of Beethoven to people. It's why he started the course. And he left a lot of his money to his summer house in Positano as a Kempf foundation. It's one of the few courses in the world where the kids who are accepted don't have to pay a penny. The tuition is totally free. They have to pay their accommodation, but Annetta has managed to get the house next door and they all live there together now. It's much cheaper for them. She has managed to persuade the mayor of the town to give them lunch every day for free. So they sometimes just survive on a pizza in the evenings.
It's a time for Bloody Mary.
Even though it's one of the most expensive summer resorts, Positano, the kids can actually live there relatively cheaply. And that's all thanks to Kempf's foresight. He always wants this course to continue.
60 Prussians tomato juice, 30 Prussians vodka, Tabasco. Nothing special. Sorry, from now I cannot speak English because my English is very bad.
Too early on a Monday morning, maybe. I just feel with some of you that you don't actually think about how to memorize well enough. You need to do it away from the piano. You need to be able to name every single note that you're going to play the key that you're playing in and the finger that you're going to play on the note, almost like a machine. So that, as happened to me, somebody in the second row suddenly takes a photograph of you with a flash, and you suddenly go, what was that? Where am I? Yes. Also, pinch there. Just pinch. Just no, go, that. Okay, now do it. Okay? Suddenly, if you engage this muscle, it helps this side of the hand enormously, that it's much stronger there. So you, I mean, either it can be like jelly or it can be very strong, depending on how you want it to help support the fifth finger. Look at the size of the fingers. This is quite thick, this is quite thick, this is quite thin. This helps enormously, this muscle. Do there, and then. Enjoy it. Yes, can you enjoy where you're going? Yes. You've got to, there are times when you've got to actually realize when a composer jumps up this, boom, yeah, then you know, I mean, if you actually, have you ever babysat for anybody? Hmm? Babysit, did you ever do any babysitting? Yes, the amazing thing about a baby is when it goes, you know it's going to scream. You can't stop it. It's going, you know. And we need to get this idea sometimes. Also, I mean, you see a great soprano going up to a top note, she'll make you wait for it. Oh, boy, and how. I mean, bum, yeah, you know, that sort of thing. And we need this in music. Yeah. So wait for it, go for it, and arrive. Not just, I mean, I often give lectures in Juilliard, and the students there say to me, you know, we can't get concerts in New York. And I said, I don't care. You know, I mean, make your own. Invite, even if you're doing an international piano competition, invite friends over and say, I'll give you a spaghetti and a bottle of wine if you sit there for a half an hour and let me play my first movement through. And tape yourself. Always tape yourself. To hear how other people are listening to you. And preferably, videotape yourself. You know, people actually don't know. Amazing the amount of people you'll see walking out on stage like this. You know, and you think, why can't you stand up straight? You know, I feel everybody going on stage should be given deportment lessons.
There's practice sessions until 9, and then after about 9, it generally ends up, because we've got a sort of porch or balcony or something, and so it generally ends up that a few of us sort of sit out on the porch and drink wine and talk and so on. And almost every single time it's ended up being all 5 of us, one by one. We never arrange it, but it just sort of happens that way. You know, people come back from the bar or from practicing or whatever, and yeah, so it's really nice.
Good. Yes. Good. And go to back down. Build up. Back down. And this. Yes, but you gave up. Don't give up on me. The dominant seventh, we know, is going to go back to C major. So yes. Yes. What fingering are you doing?
Well, there are many. I mean,
I know there are many. We have 5 in 8 chance. Which one are you doing?
It depends on which mood I am.
Well, I think you need to plan a bit more.
Yeah, well,
I mean, if you actually end up here with the fourth fingers in both hands, it means you can thumb.
John always tells us, you know, to play the Beethoven, you have to get to know him as a person, and you have to love him, and you have to feel him.
In 1802, he wrote the Heiligenstadt Testament, which is basically a suicide note, which wasn't discovered until after he died. And it was because his hearing was going. So, I mean, you can imagine the frustration of composing the first movement of this sonata with such incredible, beautiful stillness, and then sort of thinking, I can hardly hear it. Because he was going deaf.
A few years ago, when I went to Vienna, my friend took me to where Beethoven is buried. it was the first time I really felt Beethoven was human. That is, he lived in this city and walked down on the streets, and he was breathing this air and seeing these things, and it really touched me.
People tried to say that Beethoven wasn't a Christian, wasn't a believer in God. He was. He very much, it wasn't that he followed everything, you know, but the most difficult thing for him was that he couldn't get anybody to marry him. They liked him, they admired him, they had dinner with him and all the rest of it, but he didn't have intimate relations. And for this person who so wanted to be so good, that he would go to prostitutes because he had to satisfy himself. You know, and so therefore he knew about the workings of the body, he knew about the workings of the mind, he knew the spirituality, he knew all of these things. He was a man. And you have to allow all of this humanity to come out in his music. Like a dance. Okay, now this is for me one of my great memories of Kempf when he was teaching this sonata. He was 79 when I knew him first. And he said, no, this is a Bauern dance, this is a peasant dance. The men are going around in their lederhosen. He said, and then he stood up and he goes, boom, boop, boop, boom, boop, boop. You know, and he started dancing around the room. And then when it goes to piano, this other girl sort of saying, you think I'm impressed with this? You know, it was a wonderful picture. I've never been young.
I think Mr. O'Connor have this dimension to see not only the score, but see what's behind of this, behind of the of all the notes. And he tries, with all he gives, he tries to give this also to the student that he has in front of him.
Yeah, very good. I like it very much. I feel sure that he wrote this sonata for students to learn, for pupils, because he taught quite a lot of piano. I think that you have to keep this simplicity in it. I think you play it very beautifully.
I spend a lot of time pushing them, not so much to play the way that I feel it should go as to actually bring out the music a little bit more, because sometimes people have a little bit too much respect for the composer. You can see a phrase, you can play it 10 different ways. You know, you should try each way. You should listen to every single recording, but each recording only once. People who are not pianists can have favorite recordings of things, but people who are pianists need to keep their own integrity. It's very important.
So that it's suddenly there's an outpouring of absolute ecstasy.
John, actually, I don't know what ecstasy is. I know it's very good, but...
It's very difficult. How do you describe it?
Maybe...
Unless we get actually...
Like the feeling of... after tasting great ice cream, something like that?
No, it's more like an orgasm.
Ah, okay.
Good! Okay. I didn't want to have to explain that, too. Yeah, for me that's better. Also, be very careful when you're playing the piano. You grunt a lot. And you need to be very careful. That can be very off-putting, not only to an audience, but also to an orchestra. Yes. The first cadenza, it's free. Mm-hmm. Here he writes this in tempo. I think you can do a little bit of freedom, but it should be a little bit more feeling of the tempo all the way through. Mm-hmm. I mean, when he writes at the very opening...
I don't have it, unfortunately.
What?
In tempo, I can't find it. Maybe this old edition.
There's 4 beats in the bar. Mm-hmm. And you're doing it totally free.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this opening here,
yeah.
He has no bar lines. Yeah, you see?
Yeah.
It's all free.
Okay.
Here he writes bar lines.
Okay, sorry.
2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
three, four, one. Play that for me.
Something's wrong.
Yes. I prefer if you play Beethoven. Then bom, 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 bom.
Thank you.
That's what he wrote, and I think it's much better than what you're trying to play. Each one is different. And then suddenly we emerge of the light of C major. And this is one of the most thrilling moments in all of Beethoven's sonata, this extraordinary moment, that almost like it's Venus rising or something like that. Emerging into the world. It should be, I mean, for me, when the moment that for me was the most thrilling moment of my life was seeing my second son born. I mean, I was in tears. It was a miracle, him coming into the world. I still remember. It was like this. And this, for me, is pretty much what's, did you see, this is my child, my God, creation, my God. You suddenly believe in a lot of things that you never believed in. How could this happen? How could this be? And Beethoven. And Annette. Okay. Ladies first. Come and sign. Just your name and your country.